So when a star player gets traded, it sends a shockwave throughout the rest of the NBA. I mean, there's Kevin Garnett going to the Celtics, as well as Shaquille O'Neal on the Miami Heat. But for this video, we're going to be focusing on some big trades that nearly happened, but eventually did not. And we're going to start with Scottie Pippen. Now hold on, why would the Bulls ever consider trading away one of the best small forwards of all time? Well, if we rewind for a bit, as we all know, the Bulls under Michael Jordan as well as Pippen three-peated at the beginning of the 1990s, and it seemed they were on top of the world, and then MJ threw everybody through a loop and decided to retire and head over to baseball for a year. So in the 1994 season, Scottie Pippen had the full responsibility of carrying the Chicago Bulls, and he actually did a fantastic job, and they made it all the way to the conference semifinals against the New York Knicks before going down in seven games. But then some rumors started swirling around, and it was about Pippen as well as someone on the Seattle Sonics, specifically Sean Kemp. The idea of a Scottie Pippen for Sean Kemp trade was discussed a bit to where it's, you know, it's actually a news story nowadays. And of course this didn't happen, but if it did, how would this have affected the two franchises? Well, upon Michael Jordan's return to Chicago a bit later on, it would have been an adjustment for him because he never really had a pick-and-roll player like Sean Kemp. Him and Pippen didn't really play off of each other like that. Also, the Bulls would have had a drastic decrease in terms of defense and athleticism at their small forward position going from Pippen to Kukoc. And on the other side of things with the Sonics, Gary Payton would have still been the primary ball handler and the guy dictating the offense for the Sonics. But at the same time, Pippen had the ability to dribble as well, and of course that Seattle fast break perhaps could have been even better with Pippen instead of Sean Kemp. But really, let's talk about the defense. Pippen is perhaps the best perimeter defender in the history of the NBA, and Gary Payton is not far down the list either. But in my opinion at least, this probably would have made Seattle a bit better than it would have for Chicago. Our second move involves Tracy McGrady when he was still on the Toronto Raptors, who had not exploded into being one of the best players in the league upon his arrival in Orlando. But Tracy did show some signs of someone who could be really effective, especially when it came to his athleticism, finishing inside, and he almost ended up on the Philadelphia 76ers. Oh yes, Tracy McGrady and Allen Iverson could have been on the same team. Just imagine that one for a second. And it was centered around Larry Hughes heading to the Toronto Raptors with a first round pick. At the time, probably not thought of as a blockbuster move, but just think of the impact this could have had. I mean, having these two prolific scorers on the same team, I mean, they both averaged over 30 points per game, I'm pretty sure multiple times in the NBA. And neither one of these two ever had the greatest of teammates around them, so putting these two together, I mean, the Sixers made the finals once under just Iverson. Perhaps they would have went more than once with these two on the same team. As for Toronto and Larry Hughes, I mean, Hughes wasn't a bad NBA player, and there's a chance that he could have been like the perfect number two guy next to Vince Carter. I don't know, but at the very same time, it could have ended up just being kind of whatever. So, for him in Toronto. But still, the idea of T-Mac and Iverson in their primes on the same team with the Sixers, that could have been really damn good. And speaking of really damn good, Kobe was that and then some in the mid-2000s. But as great as Kobe was, specifically after the 2007 season, he felt that the guys around him were just, well, trash. They won 42 games, and, well, the team around him after Shaquille O'Neal was traded, listen, Kobe's frustrations were warranted for a reason. And if you can remember him going back and forth on different radio shows talking about, I want to be traded, I don't want to be traded, it was a wild ride. But what if Kobe was actually moved? A team he was linked to was the Chicago Bulls, who would agree on Joakim Noah heading to the Lakers, as well as Ben Gordon, who just came off of averaging over 20 points per game, if we can remember that. And one holdup in the move was Luol Deng, who had already proven himself to be a two-way player. But Kobe, having a no-trade clause, didn't want Deng involved in the move because he didn't want to go to a team that was too depleted. And, well, shout out to Tyrus Thomas because he was also in this move as well. So, of course, this did not happen. But if it did, and Kobe Bryant found himself in a Chicago Bulls jersey, his reign of terror on the NBA at this time would have continued. He was probably the best player in the league at this point. And Chicago would have been counting those blessings over the Lakers. And even with a lot of moving parts, the guys he would still have with him, Ben Wallace, not what he was in Detroit, but still pretty damn solid defensively and rebounding-wise. And, well, the idea of Lou Alding and Kobe Bryant next to each other, both of these guys at their primes, pretty damn good. And as for the Lakers, well, we have to remember that Ben Gordon had a drastic drop-off out of nowhere about midway through his career, so that might have happened again. Tyrus Thomas never became much of anything in the NBA. He's still a free agent in 2K, so shout out to him. And Joakim Noah, I mean, Laker fans probably would have loved him, but if that's all they would have got back for Kobe, it's safe to say, good move by the Lakers for not actually trading Kobe. Anyway, that's gonna do it. I'm out.